In this video, I'm going to continue our discussion on how to trigger the camera on an Android device from an Android app, capture an image, store the image to the device, and synchronize the image with Firebase Cloud Storage. Now, we know that this is going to take several steps to get through, and we're going to do the steps in kind of a funny order so that we're essentially creating a bunch of sub-assemblies that we're going to assemble all together towards the end. So I have a previous video where we talked about permissions and how to request those permissions. I also have a previous video where we set up a file provider. We will combine those concepts in this video where we create an intent and a start for activity result to trigger the camera. And then we're going to handle the return result that we get from the camera. And we're going to use that image and display it in an async image, which is a composable that we'll see on our user interface. So without further ado, let's jump right in. Since we want to save this image to the device, we want to make a unique storage place for each image that the user will take. So let's start by creating that image file. One way to make a unique image name or file name is by using a timestamp. I'll work through here to resolve some imports. Little side note, the import on date is interesting, and this is why I say we shouldn't use wildcard imports, because notice there's a class called date in java.sql and another one in java.util. So if you used wildcard imports on both of these, if you happen to need something from both packages, it wouldn't know which date to use and you'd have to qualify it. Nonetheless, the one that we want is java.util.date. Now, simple date format, I'm passing the string YYYMMDD, which is year, month, day, then underscore HHMMSS, hour, minute, seconds, which, assuming we can take no more than one picture per second, will generate a somewhat unique file name. Next, we need to get our directory where our images are going to be stored. If you remember our file provider video, we created this file paths XML file, which contains the directories where we are allowing the camera to store an image. In production, it's going to be this directory here. When we're debugging, it's going to be this directory here. And we can get this location with a function called getExternalFilesDir. Note that we simply have to pass it a key or an indication of which directory we want, and in this case, it's directory pictures. So with this, we can create a full path to where we want to save the image. So note that we invoke the create temp file function on the type called file, and we pass it a prefix, which is the file name, a suffix, which is the file extension, which in this case is going to be JPG, and then the directory where we want to store this image. We might as well remember this for safekeeping. So let's use the apply scoped function, and apply is going to action on this file object that we're creating here, and that file object has a property called absolute path. Let's save that to a new variable called current image path. Now that variable does not yet exist, so Alt Enter, and let's say create property current image path. We'll simply initialize that to empty string until it gets initialized by the camera function. Now we can make use of all of this in our invoke camera function, which before just had a dummy breakpoint in there. Start by creating our image file, and then we need to convert that to a URI so we get that content prefix, which means we can attach permissions to it when we send it over to the activity. So a couple things that we need here. First, file provider, which I just imported, and then get URI for file. We pass it a context object, which an activity can be a context object. We pass it the file that we've created from up here, and we also need to give it an authority. Let's go to our Android manifest and find that authority. So if we look at the provider that we created in a previous video, we see that it's application ID.file provider, where application ID comes from our build.gradle. And the application ID in this case is app.plantdiary, so I just remember app.plantdiary.file provider. That's also our package name. Now I'm storing this in a variable called URI, and I want to make that a property, but it's a variable or a property that I've not made yet. Let's have the IDE help us out. And create property URI, and we'll simply initialize that to null. And import the type URI. While I'm up here, I notice one thing I'm going to correct. I have laid init on this current image path, and then I was initializing it. I can't do both, so I'll simply take away the initialization. And now back to our invoke camera. I will say that I often see errors happen in this get URI for file if you did something wrong. This is a good place to put in a try catch, just so that you can set a breakpoint and debug if something does indeed go wrong. So this will give us a place to snap a breakpoint. Again, I recommend this as you're debugging. With the camera, that's just an area where I happen to see a lot of items go wrong. Now we need to launch the camera, and we'll do it using a sequence we've seen before, which is we're in our main activity right now. We create an intent. We also create a variable that's assigned to the function registerForActivityResult. We provide that a contract, which in this case is going to be a contract that will start the camera for us. And then we get the result back in a lambda. We invoke launch. We take the intent. We pass it to launch. Launch is going to trigger the camera. The user is going to take an image, and then we're going to get the response from the user taking that image. And our lambda is going to receive that response, and then we can act on it. Let's do that now. So we see we create the variable getCameraImage, which we'll invoke up above in just a moment. Then registerForActivityResult and ActivityResultContracts take picture is what we need to trigger the camera. And then we have our lambda callback starting with this open curly here and the closed curly on line 337. And then we're taking the result that we get back from the camera and we're putting it into the variable labeled success. That's simply a Boolean because the camera has already saved the image to the file path that we provided if everything was successful. There's a bit more work that we're going to need to do, but so far I'm just going to snap a couple log statements in there so that we can at least confirm that everything's working. And we can finish up our invoke camera function. So after I've received the URI here and I've saved it, after I've created the file, then I can go ahead and launch the camera. Remember, getCameraImage is the variable that we just created, and launch is the way that we tell it to start this activity and receive a result, and we simply need to pass it a URI. That is the rule that is set by the takePicture contract that we passed in earlier. Allow me to fix a small spelling error, and then let's take a look. Since we have a bit more work to do, I went ahead and brought this up in the emulator, just in play mode, not in debug mode, but I just want to confirm we can get far enough to toggle the camera. Note I click the photo button, which triggers all of this logic that we've created so far, and sure enough, here is the camera. I can snap an image, I can hit the check mark, and it takes us right back to our application. So I'm comfortable now that we are triggering the image. The next thing we need to do is display the image and also record a bit of metadata about the image. I'm going to use a library called Coil that provides us with a composable which can display an image. So I'll go ahead and update my build.gradle now. Once dependencies are resolved, I'm going to come back to my composable function specimen facts, which kicks off the rendering of my entire UI. Underneath the button bar, I will add AsyncImage, and I need to pass to it a URI and a content description. So we need to import AsyncImage, and we also have to figure out what this str URI is. Well, that's going to be a string representation of the URI, but remember, if it's a composable, we have to look at it through the lens of a state. So we need to set this up as a mutable state of property. We'll start it off like so, simply private var str URI by mutable state of. And then we can populate that URI down here in our success handler in the lambda that's going to get called back once the camera has finished processing. One other correction I realized I need to make, I put this async image down too low. It should be within the column that holds all of our user interface, and I put it right after that column. I'll show you what I mean in just a moment. So put it up one, and now you see close curly here. If I go to the top, or even if I just mouse over, we see that puts it in the column. So let's debug and see what we get. I click photo, and because I've already given permission, it doesn't prompt me. I'm going to go ahead and click the camera, click the checkbox, and we see that sure enough, underneath our user interface, that image appears automatically. Now, I set it in the debugger, but I didn't set any breakpoints, so there's something interesting that I want to show here through a breakpoint. Let's take a look at the image file that's created. Note that we get our val image directory, and let's just remember a few things from this. So the image directory is storage, emulated zero, Android data, app, plant diary, files, pictures. And then the actual image file is specimen underscore 2020, so on and so forth. As a matter of fact, it might be easier just to copy this value and put it into a text editor of our choice. I'll move the camera around a little bit using Alt and my mouse, and then snap a photo. And you see, sure enough, the user interface updates with this new photo. Now, let's take a look at a little trick. I'm going to go to View Tool Windows and then Device File Explorer. And I'll remember that path that I created earlier. So we're looking for storage, emulated, zero, Android data, app, plant diary, files, pictures, and then specimens, 2022. And let's just remember it ends with 1975. So storage, emulated, because we're on the emulator, zero, Android data, app, plant diary, files, pictures. And then under pictures, we have several specimen objects here. If you notice what we have so far, it matches pretty closely to this path that we pasted into Notepad++. As a matter of fact, it looks like this one is 1701. Let's see if we can get a bit more detail on that. Tell you what, we'll just double click on it and take a look. There we go, specimen 2022, and then ends with 181975. The same thing that we see here in Notepad. Plus 2022, and then ends in 181975. And we see, sure enough, here's the image. At this point, we can confirm that we're able to use the camera to take a photo and show it in Compose. In the next video, we'll see how to synchronize it with Firebase Cloud Storage. I look forward to seeing you then. Thank you.